Hi there, my name is Andrea Terry. I am a doctorate of physical therapy and also a vestibular rehabilitation specialist. This video is going to cover basic VOR training, where to start, how to progress, and really things that you should do and don't do. So the first thing you'll notice behind me, so as I mentioned in one of the earlier videos, so you need a target. So my target right now as I'm going through my own rehab is a dot. When you look up online or you see other exercises that are out there, some exercises will show using a letter, typically an X. When I use an X, because my eyes jump, I have a little bit of oscillopsia. The lines on the X jump, and so I can't keep my eyes stable on the X yet. So for my purposes, I'm using a dot. If you feel like you can use an X or whatever letter you want to, that's totally fine. If that's too hard, if you feel like the lines jump around, then the best place to start is the dot. So as you start this, there's going to be different things that vary. So the speed at which you move your head might be a little different, the distance from the target, the way you position your feet. So all of those things may be variable depending on where you are with your rehab. I'm going to talk about some basics and you can kind of go from there. You can adjust as you feel necessary. So the first thing to do with this exercise typically is I usually start about 6 to 10 feet away from the target. So where you have a little bit of distance. For me, when I stand further away from targets, my symptoms are elevated, but that's not for everyone. Sometimes when people stand closer to the targets, they become more symptomatic. So keep that in mind that the distance you are from the target may cause a little bit more symptoms. So the first thing I'm going to show you is VOR. I'm standing about 6-7 feet away from the target. You can increase that a little bit as you need to. So I'm going to show you what that looks like. So I'm just going to turn my back. I'm going to be focusing on the dot. My feet right now are about shoulder width apart, but you can narrow that if that feels too easy. You can widen if it feels too unstable. You can also stand on a counter if that's helpful as well. So I'm staring at the dot. I'm keeping my feet, again, shoulder width apart, and I'm going to turn my head side to side while I'm keeping my eyes steady on the target. So if I turn around this way and show you what my eyes are doing. So I'm keeping my eyes steady in one place as my head turns from side to side. So one of the biggest mistakes as people start VOR is that they overturn. So when they're keeping their eyes on the target, they really crank their neck and do this kind of stuff. That's too far. So you need to be able to see the target in both eyes clearly. If you start to get double vision, you need to either decrease the amount you're turning your head or slow your pace down. The target should not go double vision. Sometimes it can blur a little bit, but if you start turning your head and that target's all over the place, then you're missing the mark. It's not gonna do what it's intended to do. So keep that in mind. So when you start this, in a perfect world, I tell patients to shoot for 1 minute, but that might not be the case with everybody. If you're really dizzy as you start your exercises, you may have to start at a decreased time and work up towards 60 seconds. So, for example, the first day you start this, you do your exercises and you can only do about 15 seconds before you feel really dizzy. That's okay. You stop and you let your symptoms settle down and then you can go ahead and try again. Maybe working up towards the 60 seconds. But again, as I mentioned in the first video, you have to be really aware of what your symptom response is. So if your symptoms are getting really out of control and you feel really unstable and the recovery time's taking longer. So that can mean, so if you're doing your exercise and it's taking over a minute for your symptoms to settle back down, that's probably too much. The other thing too is if you do all your vestibular exercises and those symptoms are lingering between 30 minutes and an hour, then you've done too much during that session. So keep that in mind. Just be really aware of what your symptoms are doing. So that's the further target, about 6 to 10 feet away. Work up towards a minute. Again, I'm really an advocate of keeping a log of where you start because that's gonna help you keep track of your progress. So if you can only start with 10 seconds, great. Write it down, check it off on your Excel sheet where you're keeping the frequency of your exercises during the day, and then just keep working at it. So the next exercise is doing that. So the same distance, you're going to do the exact same thing, but now the difference is instead of side to side motion while you're keeping your head on the target, you're going to do up and down. So I'm going to turn my back again. So as I'm focusing on the dot, I'm keeping my feet about shoulder width apart, and now I'm doing up and down. So just like you're nodding yes to somebody from across a loud, crowded room. Let's make sure I'm on. So up and down as you're keeping your eyes on the target. Now, again, the most common mistake is really cranking your neck. So don't do that. It's going to make you more dizzy, and it also introduces more cervical spine extension. And extension tends to be more aggravating for most people, not just with vestibular disorders, but also with cervicogenic related dizziness. That cervical extension is typically not a favorable motion for a lot of people, so don't overcrank. So side to side, 6 to 10 feet away, keeping your eyes on the target, same thing, up and down, just like you're nodding to somebody from across a really loud room. That's up and down. The next exercise is exactly the same thing. The only difference that's happening now is that you're an arm's length away. So you can either hold the target an arm's length away, which I don't recommend because, first of all, that's hard for your shoulder if you're doing up to a minute. Secondly, now you've lost an arm for balance if you feel a little unstable. So my suggestion to you is to step closer to the target, so that way you have both your arms for stability and you don't have to worry about your shoulders getting tired. So same thing that I just showed you. You're an arm's length away, you're still working up towards a minute, shorter times if you need it. You're doing side to side, keeping your eyes steady, and then letting your symptoms come down, and then you can do up and down as well. So 6 to 10 feet away, arm's length away, the head motion stays the same. That's the first thing. So the next exercise is actually a remembered target is the name of the exercise. So while you have a dot on the wall, you're still standing maybe a little bit further than arm's length away, but the dot's on the wall, eye level in front of you. You're keeping your eyes there, closing, turning, and then opening as if your eyes never left the target. So let me show you that again. So eyes on the target, you close, turn, open. Now, the most common mistake with this exercise is that people overturn. So you don't need to really do a lot of cervical spine motion. It's only about 20 degrees, so you're really not giving it a lot of motion. The idea here is that you lose the target, but your eyes can still find that very easily. You may find when the VOR has been a little bit compromised that that's very difficult to find the target. You may actually find that when you open your eyes, you have to do a corrective saccade to find it. And that's okay, your eyes will get better as you practice that. And then you would do the same thing to the other side. Now, with this one, this is less of a timed exercise. This is more of a repetition. So you may need to start with 10. As 10 gets easier, do 15. 15 gets easier, do 20. So you can work on that as it gets easier. And then, of course, the other side, it would be close, turn, open on the target. Close, turn, open on the target. And that's what that looks like.